The University of Hawaii Red Hill Task Force says residents should be concerned as chemicals typically found in fuel have been identified in some Navy tap water samples. But scientists say more testing needs to be done. Jen Boniza has details.
Scientists in the University of Hawaii Red Hill Task Force say the positive results they found in some of the tap water screenings are concerning.
The vast majority of the samples we've collected are negative. They're blank. They have nothing in them. So when we get a positive detect, absolutely, if I had it in my house, I would be pushing for a proper test, and I would not drink the water until then.
The task force was formed in December of 2021 in response to the Red Hill water crisis. They've been continually testing samples of tap water since February. They created an online dashboard with the data to help the public understand the quality of their tap water and track the results over time. The dark red dots indicate positive results, meaning fuel was possibly detected. Nelson says those results were only found in water samples taken from Navy or Red Hill water sources.
One of the motivations for doing this additional kind of analysis, which is a screening, not a quantitative testing, is to be able to get answers more quickly.
But they say it's only a preliminary test and the results are not definitive for JP5 or jet fuel.
We can infer, based on the spectral characteristics, that it might be JP5, and that's why we screen it. And so it requires further testing. But we can't differentiate exactly whether we have only JP5 in the sample.
Nelson says homes with positive results have been notified. Those people are advised to do additional EPA-certified tests to find out exactly what's in the water. The Department of Health says the fluorescence screening method used by UH is not specific for petroleum products. It may detect other organic materials. In a statement, the Navy says they formed an interagency drinking water team that determined the water was safe to drink on March 18th of 2022. Since then, they are constantly monitoring it, and they say it's been consistently safe to drink. The task force receives funding from multiple sources, including the Department of Defense through the Office of Naval Research. But Giambaluca says that does not color their research.
Yes, we are maintaining independence. That's mandatory for us. We cannot give up our academic independence, academic freedom.
Log on to KH12.com for more information and a link to the tap water screening dashboard. Jen Boniza, KH12 News, working for Hawaii.